If you go somewhere and they don't receive you, you shake off your dust and you leave. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. So, for those neighbors who are not amused that we are here, oh, unto you, because you cannot fight the church and you cannot do anything against us, because we are not just here, we are not another church. Whenever you see us, we are on assignment. And we don't just do activities, we don't make noise. We praise the Lord. Amen. We are a very discreet church. Amen. Amen. I will go on. Somebody on the screen. Amen. Give me Romans chapter 8. I'll be very fast because Ronald has eaten up my time. Tomorrow, please begin on time. Because I want us to be discreet. When we say, atakama nitahubiria watu wawili ni sawa. Yes, I'm not, you know me, I'm not bothered about the empty seats. I'm not bothered because the word of God is meant for people who go. Give me Romans chapter 8, where the Lord will gather for himself. Romans chapter 8 and verse 28, we read it from the screens together by the grace of God. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Jacqueline, how are you? Give me Romans chapter 8 and verse 28. Give me 28. And we know that we are reading all of us together. And all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purposes. I'm requesting the church, please stop that silence. The Bible says the power of life and death is in your tongue. So when we say amen, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because there are people who want to be so holy, you don't even want to encourage the preacher. Say amen. Say amen. Believe the word of God, amen. Be saying something in the house of God, even if you are receiving the word of God alone. So that is Paul speaking to the church. I want us to look at some scriptures in the book of Luke 18. I had that scripture in the morning here. Luke 18 and verse 8. I'll just read that portion of the scripture. Give us the scriptures very fast because I want to be very fast. Luke 18 and verse 8. We are still in a moment of catching up. The Lord has brought us, or the church in the world, not only the church in Kenya, but the church in the world. Jesus is coming back, and the Lord has brought the church into a moment of receiving that which he preordained for their lives. So the Lord has commanded for speed. The Lord has released speed in whatever he's supposed to accomplish in our destinies. And that's why I'm requesting the church, don't cry again. Don't die in pain again. If there is something you can do for yourself from this moment, it's giving thanks.
Amen.
We read the scripture together by the grace of God. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. That is my concentration. God, sometimes God, not all the times, but when it is time for God to accomplish his agenda, he does his work in speed. That's why the scripture says king's business requires haste. He's a God who can work in haste because he is the owner of seasons and times. I want us to look at some scriptures in Isaiah 53. Isaiah 53. I want us to read from verse 3. I know some of us know those scriptures. I know we misquote some of them. So today we want to look at them very fast. I want to read the scriptures and then I'll release the word of God by his grace. Let us read the scriptures from verse 3 of Isaiah 53. This is addressing, these scriptures are speaking about Jesus Christ. So the Bible is saying he's despised and rejected. It is there who was prophesying, a man of sorrow, acquainted with what? I want you to talk to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, Jesus is acquainted with your griefs. When you are sick, he's feeling it. When people are despising you, he's feeling it. When you don't have food, he knows, he's feeling it. That's why the Bible says he's seated on the right hand of the Father interceding for us. And that's why I'm correcting some things in the world, whatever the Lord tells me. I'm saying Mary cannot intercede for anybody. Mary is not a virgin anymore. She gave birth. Holy Mary, she's not holy. She's not interceding for anybody. Dead do not intercede for the living. Jesus, you cannot say amen. What's wrong with you? He's acquainted with our grief. And we? Our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Verse 4. I want us to read those scriptures very fast. Give us the scriptures. Verse 4. Surely he has borne our griefs. Bwana asifiwe. So even before people intimidate you, people fight you, Jesus has borne that. He's feeling it. Even before you feel it, he's feeling it. He carried our sorrows. Hallelujah. Talk to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, usiniletee sorrow zako. Jesus has carried away your sorrows. I'm saying, talk to your neighbor, mama Masi. Tell your neighbor, Yesu amebeba ghadhabu zako. Usiniletee hasira zako mimi. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Yet we did not esteem him sicken, smitten of God and afflicted. Verse 5. The Bible says, but he was wounded. He was bruised for our iniquities. Hallelujah. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes. And tonight, any sickness in his house will be healed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Give me up to verse 8. Go down very fast. Verse 6. I want to show you what Jesus has gone through and what he's suffering because of whatever he's eaten. He's still feeling your pain. When you go cry because you don't have food, Jesus is going through it with you. Even if there's nobody going through the process with you, your master is going through the process with you. What a confidence we should have in the Lord. Amen. Oh, like, are we like sheep have gone astray? And we have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him. Imagine, ato akati hawaombi, ato akati nanugunika, Jesus is calling that. Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 7, the Bible says, give me the scriptures very fast. He was oppressed. You are telling me the cross is oppressing you. Jesus was oppressed. Before you go through the oppression, he has gone through it. And he was afflicted. You are telling me neighbors are afflicting you. When I could walk in my jam chair, he went through that already before he. Yet he opened not his mouth. Tell your neighbor, shut your mouth. Hallelujah. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers in death is done. So he opened not his mouth. Turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, avoid confrontational issues. Shut your mouth. Hallelujah. Verse 8, the Bible says, at the conclusion for now, he was taken from prison and from judgment. Unaniambia watu wanakuhukumu. Yeye alipitia. Hata ukilala cell, hauta tuonge. Alilala pale cell, tukaenda kumtoa. Hata ukilala huko. Hallelujah. And who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of Bwana asifiwe. Unasema sijui majirani hawakupendi, sijui watu wenu hawakupendi. Yesu alikataliwa. You are not the first one. Then you remember you are not the first one. Ati sijui watu hawakutaki, watu hawakupendi. That is why some of us, we are not affected. Utupende usitupende, tutakula ugali. When we are supposed to be fasting, we shall fast. Otherwise, we shall eat, and nobody can deny our sleep. Because the Bible says God gives sleep to those whom he loves. Hallelujah. And for the transgression of my people was he stricken. Hallelujah. That is what Jesus has gone through for us in his mighty name. Hallelujah. So I'll be speaking about those things. Write for yourself, Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6. Write for yourself. You know the scripture. We should be saying it on hand. That the good work God began, the good work, this is a confidence Paul had, that the good work God began in their lives, he'll bring it into accomplishment. I want you to go and read for yourself Genesis chapter 5, chapter 45. I love the scriptures. Genesis chapter 45, verse 5 to verse 8, the story about Joseph. I'll be addressing, well, read for yourself the book of Ruth. My mama said, remind you, God reminded you, I'll remind you again. Ruth chapter 1 and Ruth chapter 2. Go and read for yourself the book of Esther. Read the stories, because I'll be mentioning them tonight. I want to put for us Jeremiah chapter 29, a scripture we all know. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 9 and 10. I mean verse 10 and 11. We should know those scriptures on head. After the children of Israel had gone through a process for 70 years in Babylon. For that says the Lord, that after 17 years, ask your neighbor, how many years have you gone through the process? How many years have you got the process? Tell your neighbor, your years of process must be accomplished. Yes. The Bible says, I will visit you and perform my good word towards you. forcing you to return to this place. Verse 11, the Bible says, after they have gone through the ears of process, the Bible says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil. Tell your neighbor, Mungu akufikiri mabaya. So even if somebody is thinking bad about you, you have confidence in your God, amen, to give you an expected end. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, there is an expectation in my end, amen. So you can put up your Bibles. Just leave the scriptures there, Vita. We speak some few things, and then we shall be good to go today by the grace of God. I've only given you 2 points because the Lord spoke to us about 5 points. I'll be finishing the 5th one on Sunday. So today I want to speak about the 3rd one. Now, we have said it is a season for our speed. And what the Lord is doing right now, it is His own process with His Son. Now, I want to remind you some scriptures. I'll just paraphrase them. The Bible says, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. And the Bible says, as many as believed in Him, they were given the power to become the sons of God. So as long as you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you have already qualified. You don't need another process. You are already a son of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Tell your neighbor, you are a son.
You are a son.
And how many people know? Hallelujah. I have a son in the house.
Amen.
I have a son in this house. How many people know Ronald? My son, when he's this particular, this is the boy. When he's this particular age, there are things he can ask me and I'll never give as a responsible mother. Because I must wait for a certain age. So he, at an ililia, must ililia. At a kinifisha, at a thanos, where's him patia. I cannot. Atanunua mabuyu. Ananyesha kuna mabuyu hapa hivi. Atakula mabuyu na nini? Na chips. Na kebabs. Zinaisha pole pole. Pole pole. Bwana asifiwe. So the son is still a son and the father is still a father. Because the fathers are the givers of inheritance. Until we mature up, some of the things God promised us, He will never give us. That's says, the hair is still a child. My goodness. And the, whatever you are supposed to inherit is in the hands of custodians. Mpaka ufike age ile ya kuti, utimiza ile age. Mungu akiona hata kikupia lichova leo. Hautasema hapa hakuna parking. Wana sifuwa.
Amen.
Hautasema hapa siwezi ingia hakuna nini, hakuna tiles. Bwana asifiwe. So lazima Mungu akushushe. Ambie jirani yako ni mchongo, tunachongwa. We are big chongwot. Bwana asifiwe. Kama mpaka saa hii, ukiona Pastor Mwanda na design na suit, unasikia tupo shua bado hujamachua. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Kama ukiona tena na nywele saa nyingine na wewe hauna, unasikia kijio kikitu. Ambie jirani yako hiki kitu. If you are still feeling that you have not yet matured, come on, you cannot support others and celebrate them because it is not you. Bado. Tell your neighbor, bado. Yes, hallelujah. If you cannot pray for the destiny of others, you are just thinking about yourself. Bado. Hallelujah. And that's why there is a process of making. So, we have been talking about the 5 things, and we said this time around, the Lord has been, I love what the Bible says, Paul is saying that we are God's building. The Lord has been building us by His own process, using His own materials, because you are a building of God, I am a building of God. And when God is looking at me, He knows the kind of an end product He's making from my life. Hallelujah. And that's what I said yesterday, if there is something you can do for yourself this hour, it's cooperating with the Lord. Touch your neighbor on the right and left, remind them, God is saying, become with our lives.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm here just to tell you that it is going to be very fast.
Yes.
Oh, tell your neighbor the process is finished.
The process is finished.
Now let me come closer. Yes. How How many people know? I know some of you have not gone there. But how many people know? When a woman conceives, we don't see it.
Uh-huh.
First 1 month.
Oh yeah.
2 months.
Uh-huh.
Then, kama sisi wa konde, hakuna mahali pa kujificha. Lakini kuna watu wamenona. Until 6 months, unafikiri huyu bado ni kunona. Wana sifiwe. Lakini inside, something is growing. Now, somebody can hide forever. When you become pregnant, it is your seed. It is a secret thing that is happening in your body. But the secret seed will not be secret forever. A time comes, 8 months, 9 months, everybody is seeing something. Now, that is not my issue tonight. My issue is, Ronald, you have carried the seed alone. I'm talking about the spiritual seed, not physical. When you carry the seed, the prophetic word of God in your life, you have carried it, you have prayed alone, you have fasted alone, you know, maybe some of us even heard about it, and we are not able to help you. Just like the pregnant mother, nobody is able to help you carry the seed.
Yeah.
You will carry your seed to town. Tell your neighbor, it is your responsibility to carry your seed to town.
It's your responsibility.
Now, many of us have miscarried the seeds by complaining and murmuring. The best thing you can be doing for yourself from this meeting is looking for the size of a socks, the size of a kofia, na kafrana, na nowadays satani kuzuri, kuna vitu zinaitwa pampas. Enda utafute size ya pampas. Because this time around, your prophetic destiny will become a reality in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So when the woman goes to labor ward, ata bwana akimusitikisha, ata mitu akiwa hapo, ask me, I was with Catherine. Ata mitu akiwa on the ground, I was there. Nilikuwa na wakelea mikono, lakini anaenda uchungu peke yake. Baka daktari akaniambia, nilitoa mpaka nililia. Alitoa machozi nikalia. Daktari akaniambia, si wewe unaenda uchungu. I shed the tears, but I did not help her carry the pain. Hallelujah. That is why in this season, because we are finishing this, and God is finishing the deal of making us and working on our lives. That is why some of you are feeling a lot of pain, because it is at the last day. The woman feels a lot of pain. From January, maybe up to the month of September, hapo kitabu uzae, hakuna uchungu. Kuna uzito, lakini hakuna uchungu. Unasikia uzito? Shepu hakuna, lakini hakuna uchungu. Bwana asifiwe. But when you are the last minute, the last moment, the pain comes. And for those who have not given it back, I want to prepare you. Do get that pain you cannot explain.
Yes.
However, that's why, Sadat. That is why. Tell your neighbor, that is why.
That is why.
Hauna chakula. Nyumba zinafungwa. Because we are finishing.
Yes.
And God is finishing with us.
Amen.
That is why marafiki hakuna.
Amen.
Wamekuacha peke yako. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why. Unahitaji pesa za kufanya watu hakuna. The pain is much right now because we are finishing.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But we shall not give up. The mother does not give up on that bed of labor ward. She pushes for herself until she delivers that which she was expecting for 9 months. And it is the reason for this meeting is that we are going to catch up. Where we complain, where we murmur, we shall not murmur anymore. We shall not complain anymore. It is time we are hiding ourselves in prayer.
Amen.
We shall pray until something happens. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible is saying all things. That your neighbor, tell your neighbor all things.
All things.
Now, by the way, for your information, the things you are going through are not strange.
Oh, yeah.
The Bible says there are people, there are others in the world who went through the same things.
Yeah.
There is nothing strange. There is nothing strange. For those who are born earlier than us, unakumbuka kuna vitu zilikuwa zinaitwa mini skirt.
Yes.
Na nina afro.
Yeah.
Mama walikuwa wanachoma nywele wanazichanua hivi.
Yeah.
Siku hizi unaona mpaka men in the world wanachanua hiyo manywele hivyo. Kulikuwa na trousers zinaitwa mapero bottom. Wana shine nazo sahi zimerudi tena. History is repeating it because there is nothing new.
Yeah.
Mama alikuwa na bus card na hapa zinaitwa mini skirt. Sahi wewe tembea. Bwana, there's nothing new. Hallelujah. It will happen there. So God is working all things for your good. He's making you. So there's no of complaining. My brethren, when we are catching up this hour, there is no reason of complaining and murmuring. Now, if he has attained the age of inheritance, the father knows, like Abraham, he knew when Isaac was supposed to marry. Isaac was not even aware, but the father was aware. A good father will always know. So our father in heaven will always know when you have attained the age of receiving the prophetic word. He spoke in your life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So we see the book of Luke chapter 18. Don't give us the scripture. We have already read the scripture. We see a certain king in the world. A widow, that they call her the persistent widow. Jesus was giving a parable. I'm going to be very fast. And the Bible is saying that this widow was going to the king every moment, every morning. Until the king said, I don't honor man, I even don't honor God. But because this woman has persisted, she has continually prayed, she has continually sought for my counsel, I'm going to give her justice. And Jesus is saying, how much more will God speedily answer those who call upon his name day and night? And I came to say, that hour of that speed is now. That moment of that speed is now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So anything you think you are going through, again, I want to repeat before I give you the third point, is that Jesus has had the experience. He has gone through these things. So there is nothing new. So what you're supposed to do is tell Jesus, intercede for me. Unaweza ambia watu wakuombe. I have had scenarios. Tunasema tunafunga hatukuli. Unastukia ukiingia kwa nyumba ya mtu yeye ameweka kachumbari hapo na githeri. Yet you're fasting and praying for a matter. People can forget to intercede for you, but Jesus will always intercede for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So, I want to give you some examples. Number one, I want to show you the process of making. And I love the word of God. Because these 5 days are meant to encourage you.
Amen.
I don't know who broke your heart. These 5 days will revive your spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we see in Genesis chapter 45, I've told you to go and read. The son of Jacob called Joseph. I want to call it a holy process. The processing of God in his life began with his own brothers. And the Bible is saying his own brothers became jealous of his life. They became jealous. I don't know who has become jealous in your life. I've been there before, even in my personal life. Where are my own people?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Even your own people. Mm. So the Bible is saying, no, my goodness, they took him. I want to cut this short. They took him to him through a holy process, because the Bible is giving us clarity in Romans chapter 8 and verse 28 that all things, God is working out all things. And I want to let you know something tonight. God is going to surprise you tonight. Now, the brothers sought him. You know, they wanted to kill him and make him and intervene. At the end of the day, he was sold as a slave. And Joseph found himself from the pit to Potiphar's house everywhere. And there was a process of making, which was not very good. And a human being, Joseph would have complained.
Yeah.
But when you look at the scriptures, there is not even a single day Joseph complained.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, when you know it is God in it.
When you know
you are God, touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, when you know you are God is in it.
When you know
God. And I want to surprise you tonight. There is no accident for those who are born again. There is no mistake. I'm saying there is no mistake. I have been there for some years. There is no mistake. Oh my goodness, you need to read one of my books. No, there is no mistake. Some things you are like, God, are you serious? I have always told my children, I was called in Nairobi University to do BCom. Nilikuwa nimepita hesabu. Kumbe Mungu hakutaka niende huko. Mungu alitaka nikwende na shorti. My goodness. And I tulikuwa na mpaka na issue na my mother. Because now I was the mama, you cannot even borrow money or do fundraising for me to go to Nairobi University. Yet she was able to do that. But she could not do that. All things. Today I know all things.
All things.
Hallelujah. All things. My 4 years, then you can spend it cool, eh? Oh my goodness, your energy.
Uh-huh.
Oh! Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nikaishia kule, lakini saa hii naishia wapi? Wawepo, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Now, the Bible is showing us at the end of the day, I'm cutting it short. At the end of the day, the process the brothers of Joseph initiated in his life, and it was a godly process. That is why, let me show you the scriptures very fast. Let me show you. Let me show you. Give me verse 5 to 8. Very fast. Give me verse 5 to 8. Genesis 45, 5 to 8. Let us read the scriptures. I'm going to be very fast. Don't have casual see my Messiah. Don't Genesis. Mimi na wati napata begu leo. Genesis, I'll give you the scriptures very fast. Yes. Can we read together?
No.
Woo! Time to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, hallelujah, my neighbor.
Hallelujah.
Hey! You have a church in Kenya.
Oh, yes.
Now, after, imagine, walimuza, walimusha kwa shima, wakaweka, wakaua kondo, wakachukuya kondi yake baba likuwa memishomea, ilikuwa beautiful, of many colors, for the father to distinct him among the sons. Kwa sababu ya wivu, wakaichukua, the brothers conspired.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Kwa tukaambia baba, tumemua. The son not tumemua, tukaambia baba, the son is dead. Hallelujah. Lakini ana najua, how many people know, the seed of God does not die.
Amen.
The seed of God does not die. The Bible says, wakati walimaliza process yao, naye Mungu akachukulia. That's why my brother and I said yesterday, when God has come to do something in your life, he will use anybody and anything. He can use any formula, my goodness. And some of the formulas God is going to use in our lives, or he has used in our lives, they are not very encouraging.
Yeah.
Nevertheless, all things are working out for good. Nikustue, walipo muuza kama slave, akajipata, tell you nimba akajipata, in a better place, mahali kulikuwa na chakula throughout, kwa nyumba ya Potiphar.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Na akapata kibali kule, na wakuu kule, heshima akaheshimika kule, instead of being a slave, he was a prefect of other slaves in a foreign land.
Yes.
Was preparing a way for his position. Hallelujah. God was training him how to deal with the senior people.
Yeah.
God was training him manners.
Yeah.
God of process. Touch your neighbor, tell your neighbor, God of process. So tell your neighbor at the end of the day, the God of season and times. And I let that jam. Wow.
Yeah.
You have a church in this house. Nikus to it.
Yes.
Mungu atafanya mazawadanyo. So you want to mazawadanyo chuka. I pray for them. God will bring holy confusion. That one. God made sure that because he's the owner of season and times, he made sure where Jacob and the other brothers of Joseph were, there was famine.
Yeah.
There was famine all over. And God made sure where Joseph was, he had already gone through the process of making as a building of God. And God had already position him, not as a slave, the slave they saw, but as a prime minister in a foreign land. And God, Mungu akawa corona, tell your neighbor watu watakorogwa. Mungu akawa corona, wakasema tunaenda kutafuta chakula Egypt. Woo! Tell your neighbor, prepare yourself from this night.
Yes.
After you prepare your church. Maybe this is my sermon.
Yeah.
Now, prepare yourself. Na kwa kuna watu watamusho. Kuna watu watakorogwa. Waambiwe hiyo funguo.
Yes.
Enda mahali upeleke kule. Akifika hapo anapata haya. Niliambiwa nikupe gari tu ya sako nikakata. Anapata bado ni wewe. So the Bible says, when the time came, the Bible is saying, this is now where the brothers ashajieleza kwa ndugu zake wamekuja na mahitaji na hana ene grief, ene bitterness na wao amepata kama amechongwa. Ambia jirani yako tunachongwa. Saa hii tunachongwa na wale wakutupenda na asikia wakikuja saa hii tutawapokea vizuri, wakifikiri tutawarusha nje tutawapea hata mahali pa kulala because we are blessed. Watch the space.
Amen.
God is giving you two more shoes. Okay, if you give a na ile tu you have an extra one. Amen. Even to share.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So the Bible is saying, we sit it together. Now therefore, he's encouraging. He's telling your neighbor, my goodness, tables are turning. He's now encouraging them. Now, therefore, be not grieved, nor angry with yourselves, that you sought me hither. For God sent me before you to preserve life. Now, you remember, it was God's process. Number six, for these 2 years has the famine been in the land, and yet there are five, because there are supposed to be 7 years. Number seven is the number of completion. In the which there shall neither be hearing nor harvest. Verse 7. Woo! And God, when he was about it, it's God who sent me. Hey! To preserve you! From this night, your boss can be your means of transport. Be wise. Tell your neighbor, be wise. Your husband can be, your wife can be, your neighbors can be, anything. From this night, anything. Tell your neighbor, make sure your spiritual antennae are very alert. Because this time around, anybody can be used at anything to be your means of transport. Kama Joseph hake utuna ndugu zake, hake pata mahali pa. Hallelujah. So what do we see here? From this night, for you to catch up in the process the Lord has taken you, and for you to catch up to enjoy that which God has prepared for you. Like, number one, forget all your past. We see the brothers of Joseph are appearing before him when God has finished his process in his life. Forget your past. Forget the pain your people have taken through. Forget the issues you have gone through. From this night, as you go to sleep, I urge you by the mercies of God. And he's surprised by the end of the day. Huyo mwanamke tangu zikizia Yusufu. Yusufu alikuwa mtoto wake at the end of the day. And Joseph never revenged. Hallelujah. So from then remember, forget all your past. Forget what you went through yesterday. Forget what somebody took through you. Like me took you through last year. Forget it. Forget this hour for you to catch up. Forget.
Amen.
Number two, forgive people unconditionally. Are you here in the church?
Oh, yes.
Forgive people. That's why as a commission in this building, we forgive very fast. Amen. We forgive. Forgive people unconditionally. Don't hold grudges with anybody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Number three, church, for you to catch up in this hour of our prophetic divine moment, yes. Avoid any vengeance. Tafadhali, don't revenge. Eh?
Yes.
Mungu amemleta kwangu. Utajua haujui. Utajua nimeanointiwa. Unaanza kusema I kill you by thunder by force. We are killing the enemies. By the way, biblically, you have no permission to kill an enemy.
Yeah.
Where will your table be prepared? Eh? Psalm 23. Well, if you kill all of them, Ronald, where will God prepare the table for you? And he prepares the table for you in the presence of your... There is no scripture that allows you to kill your enemies by thunder, by force. That's why they are not dying, because you don't hold the life of anybody.
Yeah.
So let us allow the Lord finish the process with us in his time, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now I want to surprise you tonight. The same channel God used using the brothers of Joseph is the same to reposition him. To reposition him, even in the family setup, is the same channel God has used at the end of the day to now rightfully position Joseph back to the family. God used the brothers to sell him.
Yeah.
Now, Jacob is at home waiting, and every time desiring to see the son back, he was waiting every moment. Hallelujah. And the Bible is showing me the same brother, the same channel that was meant to destroy his life is the same channel God is again using to position. reposition him back to the family. And the positioning now, the first, the reposition, the initial repositioning was to demoralize him, to mess with, to mess his destiny up. But the positioning in the time of God was on a higher level. Oh. Hallelujah. The same brothers who took the report to the father, your son is dead, are the same brother, the same channel God is now using after he has now positioned Joseph prophetically in Egypt. It is the same channel God is now using to position Joseph rightfully in the family in his own time. And I want to surprise you, the positioning of Joseph was very fast. So this night, some of the channels you are seeing as if they are meant to destroy you, the Lord told me this morning, he's going to use the same channels to position you prophetically, to position you to see your face. Woo! The same husband, the same wife who does not believe you are truly born again. The same family members who have been taking you through issues you cannot understand. The same neighbors, the same whatever, the same channel you have been seeing as if the devil is using is the same channel and is about to rightfully position you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I want to give you one more example or two, then I'll be good to give you the that point. Now listen to this. Tell your neighbor hallelujah. Hear now the word of God. Yes. Now listen to this.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor there's a God of Mother Wadanius. That one. That one. Are you hearing that one?
Oh, yes.
Tell your neighbor there is only confusion. From this night, prepare yourself to enjoy the holy confusion. Now listen to, I'm calling it holy because it is holy. This one is not the devil. That's why we are not rebuking demons here. Even if you come with an issue that is big like this, I'll never cast out demons. There's no demon.
Amen.
It's a process.
Amen.
Now listen, Naomi and her husband and the two sons, they were disorganized by God. Again, there was famine. That's why I'm telling you the truth. Be very careful and be very watchful, because there are some people surrounding your life whom God is going to disorganize. Kutoka US amekuwa disorganized. Anakuja kusema kwa Kenya. Kisiri siri tu. Alafu kwa huduma tu hizi, Ronald. Tunakutana na yeye. Anasema nyinyi nimekuwa nikitafuta wa kanisa la kweli Nairobi. God can do anything. God can disorganize somebody anywhere. Now God disorganizes Naomi and the husband and the entire family. And look where they find themselves. They find themselves in Moab. And the intention of God was not Naomi and her husband. That is why the husband of Naomi died. The intention of God was to fetch. To Naomi was repositioned and the family. Because God had in mind somebody's life that was supposed to be divided position at the end of the day. That is why when this girl called Ruth got married to Naomi's son, she could not give birth. Tell me, there will be no sabotage.
There will be no sabotage.
Hallelujah. Yeah, the words is out where we are again. So the Bible is saying, at the end of the day, Naomi is losing the husband and the two sons, and offer goes back to her people. But this girl says prophetically,
yes,
where you go, you are God.
Yes.
She's prophesying to her destiny. You are God, will be my God. Your people will be my people. Now, I want to surprise you. Moabites were not worshippers of the true God. And this girl is now following up and even confessing that the God of Naomi will be her God. Now, at the end of the day, Naomi again is repositioned. Repositioned. Now she was going back. There's now another repositioning. Two repositions. Repositionings. Now she's now repositioned again. And now she goes back to Bethlehem Judah because he had God. He remembered Bethlehem Judah.
Yeah.
Now, surprisingly, God was not even bothered about Naomi. Mm-hmm. Naomi was a means of transport. These mabasis that bear the kijuju. Generally, but prepare yourself. Frank, by the way, somebody died somewhere yesterday night, and when I was told that man has died, that is your job. Somebody died 10 o'clock yesterday, but one night. Now, you can't find your cousin if you're not a fan. You must have been there. I don't know if you're going to catch up with you. I'm going to get a job, and I'll take you there. Somebody died. Anything can happen.
Yes, hallelujah.
Now, when it is happening, God will make sure we are connected with those people.
Amen.
So the Bible is showing me Naomi was just a prophetic bus or means of transport to go and fetch Ruth and to position her in her prophetic destiny in Jesus' name. Now, when that time comes, that's why God is commanding us to catch up. Ruth had to personally catch up. Talk to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, and you personally catch up. It is your personal deal with your God. It is good to know your season of visitation. It is good to know your moment of visitation. It is good. Now let me surprise you tonight, my brethren. When the time comes from a woman to give birth, you don't need a prophetic word. You don't need a prophetic word. The baby will come out.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. So that was a means of transport. Repositioning. Somebody was repositioned. At the end of the day, the same channel. You are also repositioned. Now, Ruth was also repositioned. And her repositioning was not for demotion. Her repositioning was for a divine positioning so that she can enjoy whatever God has preordained for her life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So what do I want to say? The same channel. The family of Naomi that was kind of a distraction in the life of Ruth, and the same channel God used to restore her destiny.
Amen.
The same, tell your neighbor, the same channel. I mean, from this night, don't despise anybody. But to me, wakue baraka. Wakupeleke kuhatima yako katika jina la Yesu. So the same praise Ruth, maisha yake ilishia usichana, hana mtoto. It is the same channel God used to prophetically position her life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I want to give you a last example in the presence of the Lord. Now listen, Esther. I love Esther. Esther was at work for Mekufa. She's now an orphan girl. She finds herself in the care of her uncle Mordecai. Now I want to surprise you. God positions Mordecai not for his own life, but for the sake of the prophetic destiny of Esther.
Amen.
Huh? Another means of transport.
Amen.
One has to feel it. Where Esther could not go by herself, God made sure there is a man who is going to be a means of transport for her destiny in the name of Jesus. The same family center where the destiny of Esther was kind of ripped up is the same channel God is using to rightly position her destiny in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God made sure there is a relative. Her relatives are dead. The mother and the father, she's an orphan now. And she's just in a foreign country, lost in there. And the Bible is showing me, at the end of the day, the same channel. Losing a family, the same channel. God is using another family member. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, I want you to turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor what God is going to do right now.
What's
I'm enjoying a word to weave. They like it or not,
yes.
They like it or not,
yes.
They will position us.
Yes.
They will fight for you.
Amen.
They will speak on your behalf.
Amen.
They will pray for you.
Amen.
They will support you.
Amen.
They like it or not.
Oh, yes.
Because all things are working out for good. Hallelujah. So this night I want to prepare you. Point number three is that from this night there is going to be a lot of repositioning for rightful or divine positioning. There's got to be a lot of repositioning. My brethren, from this night, prepare yourself. That is why we were so comfortable in a very nice hall down there. God had to reposition us so that we can see the better hall we have seen. There's got to be, there's not like an accident.
Oh, yes.
There is no accident. From this night,
uh-huh.
The things that are going to happen in your life, give them.
Oh, yes.
There is going to be a lot of repositioning.
Amen.
People are going to be disorganized. Companies are going to be disorganized. And what God is doing right now, He's going to rightfully position your destiny for His own glory in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So from this night, don't see the devil, see God. My goodness, do I have a church in Kenya?
Oh, yes.
Don't bring me the issues that Shatana mefanya. Watch out, Shatani. Hakuna Shatani hapo. We have no any fellowship with the devil. Leave the devil alone.
Oh, yes.
Cooperate with God.
Yes.
Because God and devil have no issue. They have nothing to share. They don't eat from one table. Hallelujah. So God is about to use a means of transport that are going to scare you.
Amen.
Some people make mention of your name. Where your voice cannot be heard.
Amen.
Actually, when you appear there, people will despise you. People will not understand you. But God will cause commotion.
Uh-huh.
Disorganize people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bring confusion in some sectors and some meetings and some places. But the intention of God is to pick you up and to fetch you.
Yeah.
And try to reposition you for His own glory. So point number three this night. There's going to be a lot of repositioning everywhere. From this night, I want you to be very careful. Some bosses are going to lose their jobs. Some of them are going to resign. Some senior people in this country, even in our government, they are going to resign.
Amen.
Even some judges.
Amen.
Repossessioning.
Amen.
But God is now handpicking the righteous who have gone through His process so that He can rightfully position him. I mean, position them for His own glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I finish by saying, what you are going through this night is not an accident. What you are encountering this night, even in your marriage, is not an accident. Just see God in everything. See God in the whole process. Hallelujah. And catch up with God. I remind you what the scripture is saying, that Jeremiah 29, after the children of Israel have gone through the process of God, He knew the ears He had set for them. Then He's telling them, I have now come, for I know the plans I have for you. I sent you out of the house of my father this night by telling you. Somebody may have failed to have good plans for you, but I came to introduce you to a God who has got good plans for your life. The doctor may have given you another plan. The enemies may have spoken of another plan, but I came to restore you back to the God who created you, the Father of our Savior Jesus Christ. He's saying, for I know the plans I have for you. There is an expected end for your destiny in Jesus' name. And I came to finish by saying, if God has said it, if God has said it, if God has purposed it, no demon, no enemy can sabotage it in Jesus' name. Turn to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, your life is safe. If they don't want to hear, look for another neighbor who is prophetically understanding the season. Turn to your neighbor, stand up on your feet, tell two people in the house of God, catch up. Complaining. Fit in. Stop complaining. Stand up on your feet. We are through. Stand up on your feet and tell your neighbor, fit in. We are not fighting with enemies. Fit in. Stop wasting your energy. Tell your neighbor, catch up. There is no energy for waste. There is no time for waste. Catch up. Utikita mwambie jirani, catch up. Hallelujah. Na mwambie jirani kutoka leo. Usiniambie watu wanakuonea. God has got good plans for your life. Hallelujah. And I came to finish by saying, from this night, you are going to enjoy the other chapter. Tell your neighbor, from this night, my neighbor. You are going to enjoy the other chapter, the other phase of your life. I'm saying, tell your neighbor, my neighbor, from this night. You are about to see the other phase of the God who has got good plans for your life. You are about to witness for yourself. Hallelujah. Open up your mouth and tell the Lord, Father, help me to catch up. Holy Spirit of God, help me to catch up. If there is something you can do for yourself right now, it's catching up. When Ruth, The season came for you to be.